Tony, why did you doubt Mark from the start?
I was right, right?
Apparently.
Okay. Because we're sitting down talking, just like I said, he's real fidgety, nervous, jittery. I mean, it's normal to be nervous to go to jail, whether you volunteer or unvolunteer. I mean, it's normal to be nervous and, you know, real anxious. But it was just I wasn't receiving the same vibe like I was receiving from the rest of the participants. It was just too much. It was just too, even when he, when he was just walking and we was talking, it was just, when he came in, he's real fidgety. You know, I wouldn't cut him any slack for a couple of reasons. So, like, first phase, the guys, I wasn't able to talk to anyone or, you know, we wasn't able to really reach out or we didn't feel comfortable reaching out. I felt like this group, second phase, we had enough time to build somewhat of a relationship. I mean, we didn't have, you know, hours on hours and hours, but we had enough time where I think everybody felt comfortable enough where Donovan, I think you felt comfortable to come to me and vice versa, yeah. And y'all too as well and everyone else. So for you to just to make that decision for yourself, I mean, even though it's for yourself, your safety is extremely important. I feel like you had the resources that, you know, could pull you back in. Like, hey, look, we got you. What you need, what you want. You need some food. You need to talk to somebody. You need to, you know, you want to come in my cell, however you want to play it. And I don't feel like you use your resources.
Inmate Caswell. I mean, she was tormented verbally and physically by the people who were supposed to keep her safe, who are bound to keep her safe. And to know that if they're the ones perpetuating it, I was fearful. You know, when would it end? What would stop it from going further next time? Just very fearful and hopeless.
Did it kind of bring you to a breaking point?
I wouldn't say it brought me to a breaking point. I would say it was the epitome of how bad it is in there if staff are that corrupt. That's the icing on the cake. That's as bad as it can get.
Was it a turning point for you in your career?
You know, you see all the bad publicity that police officers and correctional officers and those in law enforcement get. And I think naturally, being in our profession, you kind of give us the benefit of the doubt. When I see a bad clip on TV or on the news about law enforcement, I give them the benefit of the doubt because I'm one of them, and I wouldn't do those things that so many people accuse us of. Right. That opened up my eyes that, unfortunately, there's some of us that do those bad things. And as bad as I don't want to admit that, it's true.
Sheriff, why'd you decide to do phase two?
Well, we learned a lot from you guys in phase one, and look, if it saves one life, if it makes our jail more efficient and more safer for the correctional officers and the inmates, and if going through a process and exposings and through transparency makes this jail a safer place, then it's worth it all the way. So that being said, when we were offered the opportunity after we learned some of the issues that we had, which is a new sheriff who inherited a new jail with 212 plus broken door locks, windows and cameras that had not been operable in 3 years, to take and have that opportunity and then be given the opportunity to make some changes and let those set and let those gel and solidify and have another group come back in and sort of kind of, you know, as a report card, give you a grade of where you're at now and even tie up or shore up or show you a little more that you can fix. After we made some changes the best we could, which was a still short period of time, was just icing on the cake. Sure, bad things, and even in that section, could be shown. But that gave us twice the opportunity to make the place twice better than what we inherited.
And what people don't realize, too, is during the whole process of the 60 days in, is roughly it was around 11 correction officers that was either terminated or resigned. That's 11 people that's bad that could be spreading, you know, bad things for
us. That's progress.
It was actually 17. There was 11 resigned. Yeah. There were six terminated. And of those six, three were arrested with criminal charges.
Man, nice.